just there. There's a couple of deer head. It's his ears. There was another one, just to the right. I ran into the trees. He's there. That is incredible. It's only the second time I've ever seen deer, and never this close to the road. Fantastic. I don't know if he knows I'm here. There's no wind to... It's just... Where is he? He is just... There somewhere. Fantastic. Right, we're gonna attempt to make some bannock bread today. And bannock bread is relatively easy to make. Just need some self-raising flour. I suppose about 2 or 3 cups in there, but you can do less. I've put in about. So about a cup and a little bit in there. And then you put salt and pepper in. I think you can use self-raising or normal flour. But for this purpose I've made with self-raising flour and a little bit of powdered milk. Salt and pepper, as I said. And you can put raisins or nuts, that sort of thing in there. Yeah. Need some water. You may need to add a bit more flour, because the idea is that you get into a bit of a dough. Now it doesn't need proving, so you haven't added yeast. So you just get that mixed together. Once it's all mixed together, then you can add a bit more flour. And as I said, you've got to just make a bit of a dough. Probably the rest of this, but we'll add a little bit of time. Actually, I'll add the rest of it. I've made this once before, I made it at home, and it turned out absolutely delicious. Tastes a little, just tastes like bread really, but without that kind of full bready taste. Messy. Definitely not the tidiest cook in the world. So that's that in a day. Now, add a little bit of oil to a pan. This is my little frying pan here. You don't need loads, that's just a little bit of olive oil in a little pot that. From Greece, Crete, like that. Mix that down. Let that warm up. Excuse me. It's making nice. Now that that's warm, take off the heat. Just place it in the pan. Wash that off in a moment. Just squash it down as flat as you can get it. There we go. And just stick that on the fire. And just basically fry it. And that's all you do. I'll get back to you when it's finished. So one side's cooked. When I say cooked, slightly charred, but that all adds to the flavour. But I'm no expert. Especially with open fire. But so far it looks good. I've also got underneath there, I've got some char cloth going away as well. I ran out the last lot and Sounds like the farmer's having a shoot. Safely say when it's done. There you go, Bannock Bread. Well, I've been told it's tradition to split it, so you pull it apart and not to tear it. It's a sign of bad luck or something. Just come out of the woods after a bit of Bannock Bread, a cup of coffee, and I've seen this field in front of me with some nice lines that the tractors have made through the wheat. And we're going to get a nice panoramic shot as it goes across. So I'll show you that now. As you can see, nice skies, nice dramatic cloudy and blue skies, which is what I love. Just waiting for the right moment. With the settings, I'll probably be using, if it stays the same, around about 250 a second, f9.5, and an ISO of 50. It's quite bright around here. And I've just, I'm gonna underexpose just a tad, just because slightly changed. So we've got the new settings are 1/80th f8 and we have ISO 50. That last shot was also in a landscape. We're going to do another landscape one here. Just going across the edge, looking down towards the edge of the woods, down that way. You can see. Settings are 1/80th, although slightly exposed. Bring that down to 30th of a second, f8, and about 2 stops down on ISO 50 as well. And we're gonna focus stack 3 images, one straight down, another one, and then up to the top of the line of the tree.